This is GitHub, the largest host of source code. You can take someone else's code and use it in your own project, or you can just use this software for free. It's called open source. 100 million developers worldwide contribute to open source, Google, Microsoft, Nvidia, and many other global companies. But what is the point? Why do people and companies invest in free software? What open source is about? Voluntary or business? Let's find out together. First, a few words about what open source is. Open source is a software that is designed to be publicly accessible, so anyone can see, modify, or distribute it. It's a bit like a recipe that is shared publicly. Anyone can see the ingredients and steps, can try to make it themselves, adjust or share it with others. But why do people develop programs and put them in the public? In addition to creating these programs, they need to maintain, develop, update, and provide customer support. And this is at least time, efforts, and costs. Today, all companies and people are obsessed with intellectual property rights, patents, trade secrets, and NDAs, so that no competitor would find out what they are doing, let alone know their code. And here is a code. Here you go, and you can use it. What's the catch? When they say open source, the first image that usually comes to mind are these cool guys. But open source didn't start with them. We'll come back to them later. Open source was born in an academic environment, and that is not a surprise. Authentic knowledge is free. There are no laws of physics under NDA. In science, it always has been encouraged for scientists to share and openly discuss their findings because theories and technologies are based on the previous findings. Who do you think has become one of the leaders in making money on the software? Microsoft. In 1975, Paul Allen read an article in a magazine about a new personal computer and told Gates about it. Gates contacted the president of the company and told him that he and their friend were working on the software for that computer. But in fact, Gates and Allen had nothing to do with the computer, just emulating the processor. Fake it till you make it. The president of the company invited them to his office. They demonstrated a working basic language entrepreneur, and a few weeks later, Paul and Bill were already partnered with MIT's and got royalties from the copies sold. The company was named Microsoft. And it would seem that the period of open source is done. Computers became private, people realized that they could make serious money on the software. How has open source survived to these days? Remember we mentioned these guys? You may have heard about the Linux operating system. They are the ones who did it. Stallman was a developer at MIT AI Lab. He was disappointed by the move of non-free software in which users could not get access or modify the code. He decided to create a completely free and open operating system. Stallman developed many utilities that an operating system needed. However, one major component of the system was still missing, the kernel. Linus Torvalds, a Finnish computer science student, independently began to develop a free kernel known as Linux. The puzzle came together. The Linux kernel, with Stallman Systems GNU, provides a fully functional and free operating system, GNU/Linux, or commonly called just Linux. By the way, this is not a totally geek story. Linux is used today by at least 33 million people. Do you know these guys? They built the most popular browser of 1990s, Netscape Navigator. But when Internet Explorer came out, it was pushing Netscape out of the market because it was distributed for free within Windows. As a result, Netscape had no choice but to close. Explorer grabbed 19% of the market. Except for one last thing. They decided to open the source code of the browser. Later, it became the foundation for the Mozilla Firefox. Okay, this all sounds like a social movement against code privatization and for freedom of information, knowledge sharing, etc. So that means that open source is all about volunteering and non-profit, or not? Well, for example, these companies. They have built their businesses entirely on open source. And no, they are not non-profit. Companies usually use the following business models or mix of them. First, support or professional services. In most cases, the company doesn't own the technology, but borrows open source code and provides various support services for money.
Have you tried turning it off and on again?
Red Hat was one of the first companies to monetize open source. Red Hat makes money on subscription for the support, training, and integration services that help customers. Customers pay one set price for unlimited access to the services and 24/7 support. The company was very successful. In 2018, the company was bought by IBM. Second, hosting or SaaS. Next approach is be my guest. Classic software as a service model. WordPress is the best example. It's an open source website builder. Almost half of all websites are based on the WordPress. You can build and manage your website for free, but it has to be hosted on the web server, and WordPress can host it for you for additional cost. And the third, premium or open core. Only part of the product is available for free. The rest of the features are chargeable. This model is most popular, and one of the examples is MongoDB. It is easy to use database software. They started in 2007 with a dream to build a flexible and scalable database. 2 years later, they went open source. They believed in the power of community, and the gamble paid off. Developers loved MongoDB and started using it from startups to Fortune 500 companies. And later, MongoDB started offering commercial services. Less common business models are partnerships like Google pays royalty to Mozilla for being default search engine, branded merchandise, crowdsourcing, and donations. But open source is used also for hiring, marketing, PR. The State of Enterprise Open Source report said that 82% of IT leaders are more likely to select the vendor who contributes to open source community. Did you know that without Linux and open source software, there would be no Google?
What?
In its early days, Google, like many small companies, used open source software, particularly Linux, to build its infrastructure. As Google grew, it continued to utilize open source and contributed back to the community. Another huge open source contributor is Microsoft. Acquired GitHub and helped open source several of their technologies. Microsoft positions itself as a leader in the open source community, enhancing its brand reputation among developers. NVIDIA encourages developers to use their hardware and software. For example, NVIDIA CUDA Toolkit, which is used for parallel computing on NVIDIA graphics processing units, includes several open source libraries. Alibaba open sources several of key technologies. They do it in order to promote the use of their technology on global scale. But it is not only companies that benefit from open source. The key players are developers, millions of guys around the world who have built a strong community, where you can share knowledge, look up, get and give advice or help to improve if you know how. And all your activity on the GitHub is essentially your CV. Everybody can see all achievements, comments, creations where your comments were accepted in the production audits. And yet, open source is volunteering or business. It seems that everyone has their own agenda here. And there is both social motivation like knowledge sharing and a desire to make money. If it was interesting, like and subscribe, let me know what you think about open source in the comments, and stay tuned. Bye!